Get ready to be horrified. Here is a demonstration of the brand new capabilities of actually something related to this last video, the Boston Dynamics Robot Atlas.
Is that a thing a lot of people are going to want their robot to do?
I don't know, but...
Do they show the guy afterwards? Does he say what it was like?
What's that?
Does he say what it was like being in that suit?
The guy in the suit?
It was not the only guy, unfortunately.
No, really?
It was a 6'9" robot. We've previously seen videos of it, you know, like walking and stuff like that, recovering from being shoved.
So the robot's name is Atlas?
Yes, exactly.
Okay, because I thought that it was a robot Atlas.
Right, he's going to say, and this is where Diego Garcia
right,
is.
Right, exactly. The best route to get from Denver, Colorado, to Helena Montana.
But so there you see it failing. So look, this entire thing is
again, that was a bad
attempt. Show the fail one more time.
That was great. Oh yeah, you can see it go wrong.
No, he sets his landing.
Oh, he's trying. This one is just, he had a little bit of trouble.
Oh, okay, all right.
Yeah. The Russian judge, not gonna like that. Oh.
I thought it was super weak when he like jumped, he was jumping from blue sort of whatever that
boxes
is,
or
blue
yeah.
boxed, and then it was, but it was too far, so he just jumped on the ground first.
And then he jumped on the big one.
Yeah.
But, right, well, yeah. Look, if you haven't been following these robots, and I actually have, that's amazingly difficult. I mean, it's a 6'9", extremely heavy, extremely complicated robot that can now do backflips. I mean, can anyone at this table do a backflip? I couldn't even do
the
failed backflip.
No, but I'm not 6'9", so
that's true.
Yeah, that is unbelievable. I mean, it really was. Freakish.
Once you can get to that, I mean, God knows in a year.
But
in
I
10
also
years,
like that
capable.
It kind of screwed up too.
I mean, it's not perfect.
Right, yet. Right. So I mean, I see this and I think, look, that's not going to make our lives easier. That's not collecting my laundry. That's getting a gun and that's going to fight. And that's
probably
you know, right.
So that's one of the reasons.
And it's the military, so sometimes it'll
mess up,
fall down.
Yeah.
It'll fall down, or it'll mess up and shoot the wrong person. Yeah. So look, this isn't immediately necessarily a military thing, although their previous four-legged sort of pack animal robot has been tested by the military. But you can't look at that and have watched the movies that we've watched growing up and not think the military is looking at that. That is going to be one way, just like with unmanned vehicles in the air, they're going to be able to extend military power without the threat of actually losing a human.
American.
That's a good point. So, an American. And God knows what effect that'll actually have once it gets deployed. And those things, by the way, are not
going
to be cheap.
And then when it's all robots going, we really don't have to stand up for the national anthem, right?
real quick, what movie did you think of first?
When I see that, I mean, I think of Terminator.
Yeah, I was Notting Hill, Michael.
Ordinary People.
Yeah, totally. Yeah.
Okay, I don't get that. But anyway,
you said the movies we grew up with.
This is the movies we grew up with.
Ninja Turtles. Right. I don't know. But anyway, look, for right now, that's an interesting technological thing, but it's going to have huge economic and especially military implications at some point.
If you like this video, you'll love the whole TYT network. Check it out at tytnetwork.com/join.